I'm no stranger to public transportation. While it was never really a big part of my life, I had been known to utilize the city's transit system from time to time. Whenever my friends and I would get together across town to see a film or meet up somewhere and hang out, we'd all pay a small fee and ride the bus to our destination. We also didn't have vehicles of our own at the time, so that made the decision much easier for us. After college, I was lucky enough to get an IT job downtown in the city. It wasn't anything extravagant, but it paid well and there were some decent benefits. The only caveat was the location. The office was located in a high-rise towards the heart of the city, and I'm not sure if any of you venture downtown to your major cities frequently, but the traffic there is abysmal. After about a month of just barely making it to work on time, even with waking up extraordinarily early, I decided to try something else to save my sanity. Following that month, I bought a bus pass, just to see if it would be better than trying to drive. It took me a few days to get in the habit of walking to the bus stop, waiting for the bus, and journeying to my destination, which admittedly wasn't a great distance to travel. I was late on my second day due to the bus being a bit late, but for the most part, it seemed like this would alleviate some of my headaches of trying to drive. It wasn't until my fourth or fifth week using the bus system that my coworker Frank asked why I was using the bus. He wasn't saying that with any disdain. As he continued, he told me that the subway would probably be much faster and more direct than the bus. I pondered it momentarily as I hadn't really used the subway before. He gave me a whole spiel about how simple it was. All I needed to do was purchase a pass and then tap it on the kiosk. He then offered to show me after work, and since I didn't have much going on, I agreed. After our shift ended, the sun was on its descent. Frank and I walked our way to the stairs that descended beneath the road. He led me over to a machine to purchase a pass as well as a map on the wall. I looked at the map and was fairly surprised to find that there was an exit about half a block from my apartment. He then checked the times and told me which platform to go to, and we parted ways shortly thereafter. I waited for the train to arrive, and I boarded with a few other evening passengers. After only a few stops, I disembarked and sauntered up the stairs to the road. Sure enough, I was a very short walk away from my home. The next day, I journeyed back into the subway and made it to work on time. The train was a bit more compact with other commuters in the morning, but it wasn't terrible. When I arrived, I thanked Frank for his recommendation and told him that I would probably be using the subway much more often. For the better part of half a year, I had become much more familiar with the subway. I used it often, even when I wasn't commuting to work. I had a few small gripes here and there, but overall, it was a decent experience. A few months ago, I started seeing signs cropping up around the subway about a new line opening soon. One which had more direct routing throughout the city, or better architectural designs. I'm not entirely sure. All I know is that the signs were trying their best to hype up the new transit line, and that it was slated to be finished towards the end of the year. Fast forward to a few days ago. The new line had opened, and while I was curious about it, I hadn't really had time to utilize it. I didn't want to take a chance on it and potentially be late for work again. So the days continued until one evening. My boss asked me if I could finish up a stack of tasks that he needed by tomorrow morning. Without wanting to bring home a significant amount of work, I decided I would just run the clock and attempt to finish it there. By the time I completed the last line of tasks, I rubbed my eyes, which had been strained by the bright computer in the dark office. I looked at the clock and noticed it was much later than I was anticipating. I shut everything down and left the office. As I stepped out onto the sidewalk, the winter air chilled my lungs. I zipped up my coat and walked off towards the subway. It was odd being out here this late. There were hardly any people about. Just the odd car driving by or a person staggering down the sidewalk who appeared to have drank too much. Still, there was this eerie quiet to the city streets. I exhaled into my hands and picked up the pace. It wasn't too much later that I found the subway entrance. I descended and quickly tapped my card on the gate. I walked briskly to my platform and stood there in the silence. After around 2 minutes or so, the train appeared and with it a soft hiss of the doors as they opened. I made note of how pristine this train looked. The sides were adorned with advertisements for the new subway line, and I wondered if this could be one of the new trains. I stepped inside and was surprised to find quite a few people were riding the train as well. They all seemed to be minding their business, so I did as well. I found an empty seat, and after a few seconds, the door slid shut with another hiss. As the wheels engaged, I felt the train lurch, and we were on our way. I tried to pass the time by using my phone. As I stared down at the small screen, a yawn caught me off guard, and I looked at the time. I had been riding this train for nearly 45 minutes. None of my previous trips in the past took over 20. I glanced up and felt my jaw tense. All of the other passengers were now staring at me. Their faces were twisted into these unsettling expressions. Their mouths were stretched to the sides of their faces like they were all trying out for the circus. My phone began to shake in my hand as I couldn't seem to look away from their eyes, swirling dark orbs that looked like smoke trapped in marbles. The lights in the train began to dim and flicker at random intervals. I noticed something else in those few seconds apart from the terrifying passengers. In the windows of the train, as the tunnel flew by rapidly, I spotted more people just standing outside of the train. All of their faces mirrored those of the passengers inside with me. Suddenly, the light in the train extinguished and I could hear movement shuffling around me. I held my breath as the train rocked back and forth. I shut my eyes and tried my best not to move an inch. I was silently hoping that I would open my eyes and be at my stop, and that this whole ordeal would just be a product of fatigue. Though, when I cracked open my eyes, it was still dark in the train. In a flash, the lights came back on and went out again. And in that split second, I saw all those passengers were now standing around me, still looking at me with those eyes. Despite this terrifying situation, I found myself asking what they wanted. A moment went by, and I thought perhaps they couldn't speak, when suddenly a raspy voice like sandpaper cut through the ambient subway.
"We want your eyes. We want your light. It's so dark down here."
Suddenly, I felt a hand grab onto my face in the darkness. Ice-cold fingers wrapped around my forehead and temple. I punched the arm away and rolled out of my seat, trying desperately to put distance between myself and them. Oddly, when I got up and took a few steps, I didn't bump into anything. Even though I had spotted all of the passengers standing around me moments earlier, I backed all the way up to the end of the subway car and shut my eyes tightly. Another hand rested on my shoulder, and with a scream, I instinctively raised my arm to strike back at whatever was touching me. It was an older man, looking at me with concern. Suddenly, I realized that I could see again, that the light in the train was back on. I looked around me, and a few passengers were looking at me concerned, but most were still minding their own business. The old man asked me if I was all right, and I felt the train lurch to a halt. The doors opened, and I quickly rushed outside. I was at a stop a few blocks farther than my normal departure, but I didn't care. I walked quickly home, trying my best to regain some composure. I don't know if it was simply some fatigue-induced hallucination or if what I saw was real. I think I'm going to take a few days off from work to clear my head. And I think I'm going to stick to using the bus from now on.